G'd him. Took a pic with Rico. Niggas say I showed my soul. Time pound me head to toe. You niggas is really broke.
Disgusting.
Bougie took a pic with Rico. Niggas say I sold my soul. Time pound me head to toe. You niggas is really broke.
Disgusting.
Hey yo, blue six figures on the Beamer just because I like the grill. Yeah, nigga, ice is still. Yeah, I fuck your wifey still. Neck about a half a mil. Wear my Yeezy Nike still. Niggas doing headshot kills. Yeah, my shooter on the bill. Model bitches on the pill. Fucked out of Prada Hill. Nigga worth a lot of mil. Swoosh, nigga, rich, I mil. West coming, beat this pussy. Bitch, I'm in London still. Look at me and see the real. 100 bricks, I got to chill. Now I know how Jordan feel. Bitch, you can't afford me still. Been in the 4 hours. Bottle bitches pouring still. Yeah, I push a foreign steel. Horses on the wheel. Turn 1 to 3. Wet, wet, fly, got copper feel. Yeah, nigga in the hood. Body nigga bougie though. Took a pic with Rico. Niggas say I sold my soul. Time pound me head to toe. You niggas is really broke.
Disgusting.
Bougie though, took a pic with Rico. Niggas say I sold my soul. Time pound me head to toe. You niggas is really broke.
Disgusting.
I get money, that business challenge, I'm twisted. A bit off balance, and them hoes, your clique can have them. That juice shit, my clique got gallons. Yeah, burnt bridges. Fuck that, that weren't my business. Got this bitch here, I don't like bitches. For that party, I spent 5 figures. Good intellect. He ain't real, it's just internet. I got them things on deck. I'll let my bare hands ring your neck. I got the Magda Simpson. He bought that thing from Chingford. Told her she looked mad sexy. She said she's from St. Vincent. You got friends, just bring them. Step in the magic kingdom. Look at that back, just spin that round. They know I love to spin them. I quickly make this telephone call, cause she's going back to Finland. None of you nerds ain't got no balls. These niggas are rats and minions.
Yeah, nigga in the hood, but a nigga bougie though. Took a pic with Rico. Niggas say I sold my soul. Time pound me head to toe. You niggas is really broke.
Disgusting.
Yo, what up, everybody?
What's good?
What's that gun go hard?
I like yeah. That album goes hard.
Oh, man.
Some music news that just popped off as we started recording. Pusha T and Malice together again as The Clips. Official album title, Let God Sort 'Em Out, produced entirely by Pharrell.
Oh.
Late 2024.
Oh, holiday.
Known features include Nas, Stove God Cooks, and John Legend.
John Legend's going to be singing.
Apparently, they were also waiting on one feature. So that's all people saying. It could be Kendrick. Which would be fucking insane.
Crazy. Going crazy with him. With him going crazy would be crazy. Sensation.
I kind of think it might be Jay-Z.
That would be nice.
They've done a song already, yeah. But yeah. I would love to see another collab.
Big ball of shit right there.
But who knows?
Yeah, we'll see. And probably November area, I will say. Maybe Christmas time. Drop a hate album.
I mean,
that'd be crazy.
I feel like there's definitely going to be some shit said about Drake.
Of course. That'd be funny. Oh, man, that'd be wild for the fact that that if that shit pops off, well, this stuff. Because Drake apparently put it on his. I never heard this new songs he put on Instagram.
Yeah.
The talking about sparking up the beef again.
The No Face one?
Yeah, I didn't.
That should go hard.
I haven't heard it. It's because it's not, I don't want to hear it through, I mean, I guess I just bite the bullet by hear it through Instagram, but I try to look on this like,
100, it's on,
100 gigs?
It's, you dropped it like this past weekend or something.
Okay.
Yeah, on, it's on Apple now.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
Oh, shit, let me go check it on the way back and see, hear it, see how it is. I didn't know that. And I guess I'm not even paying attention to what he's doing. Honestly, not.
I just see it like whenever, because people like just start just reposting it and stuff.
Mm-hmm. What I've been seeing repost is,
Damn.
I don't know if that shouldn't be mine.
No, yeah. It's from the courtyard.
Oh, okay. Well, I have a little background beep for a little bit, but that kind of ruined my train of thought, not gonna lie. But, wrestling news, I heard, I don't know. If you know, there's this guy named Odyssey Jones who's new.
Mm-mm.
He just started about a couple month or two ago on WWE's like main roster because he was on like the G League NXT.
Yeah.
But he supposedly is now removed from the WWE website, but has no official thing yet. But everybody is saying that he's probably removed due to the fact he has a domestic violence charge on him.
Yeah,
there hasn't been any charges technically charged to him yet.
Yeah,
but they're thinking it's part of that, and it's crazy because if it is true, this dude, big man, he's 6'5", 405 pounds, and very athletic and agile. So bless you.
Thank you.
So like, if he was some domestic violence, he put someone through a wall. That's like an inch taller than me, and like. Almost 120 some more pounds.
Yeah.
A whole human. It's crazy. But I did not like, that's because he was just in the main, like they just put him in a storyline that's actually kind of building up.
Yeah, this is fucking, okay.
There it goes. they just put him in a new storyline. Like, he just started in, and then the past few Raws he hasn't been in. Everybody's like, what's going on?
Yeah.
And then yesterday, it was showed on wrestling's website that he's been taken off of the mainline roster on the website. And they do that quick. Like, if you're no longer part of it, you are off then literally the following day.
And it's crazy.
Yeah, so big, and he was in his persona was a big happy guy, just trying to help out, doing whatever for the team he was helping out. Because part of the New Day, Kofi Kingston, Xavier Woods, I think his name is, and there was actually going to be a big storyline with that.
Damn, yeah,
shit in my hair. There it is. And but I guess they're going to stop. I don't know if they're just going to cut the story, end it right there, and just like start something else, or. Write him off because he hasn't been there for that long, but he was going to be the next big star. Like, you can tell he's going to be like, oh, this dude's going to be a problem because, I mean, 6'4", 405, big dude. There's not that many big dudes moving like that. There's some in wrestling, but they're not moving like how he was. So it's crazy.
Yeah.
Don't be beating up nobody domestically. That's crazy. I don't know if it was his wife, girlfriend, brother, sister, family member, something. He beat up somebody.
That's wild.
So, yeah, it's wild to me. I can't believe it. Damn.
Oh, speaking of some domestic violence, Oasis supposedly getting back together.
Talk about a nice way to lead. What's it called?
Transition.
Segue that.
No, I was listening to like just all the times they basically almost broke up leading up to when they did.
Yeah.
And like they would just get into like fights with each other at like clubs and studios and stuff.
Big fight. Yeah. And
I believe Liam broke a fucking cricket bat over Noel's back or something like that.
Oh, those things are and big then too.
It like sold at like auction or whatever.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
I would love to get that look here.
Wouldn't that have to be like police evidence?
I have no idea.
Because
it depends if you like filed like assault charges on him or whatever.
Oh, just kept the bat, I guess.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
God, I've been hit with the chair in my back before, and that shit hurts, and by a wooden chair, and as a kid. But fuck, a cricket bat as an adult.
Yeah, dude, that would be...
A breaking one?
Yeah.
Oh, because I've seen how people break bats and when they play cricket, and the ball's moving really fast, and they're swinging the shit out that.
Yeah.
Fuck that. Damn.
But, yeah.
That could stun anybody.
They broke up in 2009. Apparently have not talked to each other since.
I would have shot the dude. I'm sorry.
It seemed like Liam, who was like kind of the... It seemed like Liam was the one that was like really hard to work with. Noel's the one that wrote like all the songs, but Liam was like the front man.
The singer?
Yeah.
Okay.
So, he was like just real hard to work with. Apparently, he like showed up to their MTV Unplugged just hammered.
Oh, shit.
Every time they were doing sound check. And then, like, they went on, and he kept, like, complaining he was, like, sick and his throat hurt or whatever. So they ended up, they were going to just cancel it, but then Noel was like, I'll just sing. Like, fuck it. And it was, like, people were saying it was kind of cool, like, initially, because it was like, oh, this is the guy that, like, wrote the songs and was getting this, like, moment to, like, sing and perform it and shit.
They think it was a heartwarming moment.
Yeah, but then apparently Liam came back in and was in the, like, balcony and shit, just drinking and getting fucked up. Ruining and then it. Just yelling and, like, heckling him and just being like, you're a shit!
Oh, my God.
Like, stuff like that.
Fuck that, yeah. The dude who puts in all the work and all that, and then the guy who's just the sing the talent and then got, you know, ego big and...
I mean, he was good, too. Like,
yeah, I'm not saying he wasn't, but he's just like... He got to his head that he was a front man and started, you know, the rock star lifestyle, you know. Big shot.
But apparently, like, kind of recently, like, Liam was like, yeah, I'd be cool with, like, in the band back together, like, all this stuff. And it seemed like Noel was kind of like, nah, like, fuck him.
Yeah, I don't blame him.
But,
would you? Exactly, yeah.
They came up with some type of thing, and so they got 6 shows planned out. There's, like, bets on how many shows they're going to get through before they break up again. People were also saying... that it's probably some type of test thing that if they can make it through 6, they might do like a bigger
tour
because it's only in like the UK and like one Ireland show.
Yeah. No, that makes sense. I mean, why invest when you don't know how like stable the front man is? Like, how the chemistry between the band is.
Yeah, like this could be like the first time they've interacted with each other in years.
Yeah.
And just the simplest inconvenience seems like it could set them off.
God damn it. Well, that's how it is. I don't blame. Yeah.
But I will say I do want both of their Adidas models. But Liam, I think, has 2 and Noel may have 1.
Okay, I didn't know that.
Yeah, with Spezial.
The Spezial. Did this come out like early 2000?
Semi-recently, no.
Okay.
Yeah.
I didn't know that. Adidas Spezial.
Well, the Spezial line. I forget the dude that does that. Gary something, I think.
Gary Spezial. No, I'm playing. That'd be funny. That'd be really funny if that was his last name, Spezial.
Yeah, these Noel ones I want a lot. The Adidas Garwin Spezial.
Garwin.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's kind of like a boat shoe almost.
Yeah, the leather looks nice.
Yeah.
Okay.
Can't really find them in my size though. Let's see what else.
Damn. It says here.
Yeah, so Liam has 2. Or I'm sorry, 3. He has the Liam Gallagher Spezial, so his own kind of model.
Okay, the white.
Yeah, it's like a white kind of cream. I believe it's got his like face shot in the
tongue,
like a Stan Smith kind of. Yeah, he dropped one last year with Speziale, the LG2. Well, you know, nice. White and green.
Simple.
I'm sure it's based off something. I just can't find the... And then an LG2 and cream.
Okay.
It looks slightly different again.
Yeah.
But, yeah, fire shoes. Oh, they have a pair for $400 on GOAT. My size.
That's a lot.
Yeah.
Say, I'll give you 200.
They don't have a 13.
No, of course not. What even with those shoes?
Let me know. On the white and green pair, they do have a 13, but it's 500.
Nah.
You could try 12 and a half for 160.
Dude, that's a very big difference.
Yeah.
That's a huge difference.
11 is 200.
12 and a half, I'm squeezing that.
And
depending on the shoe fit, it fits how it fits, it could fit better.
Yeah, they don't have an 11 for the Gallagher 1. They do have a 12 and a half, though, for 330.
It's just crazy how a half size can jump almost fucking $350,
$400. Yeah.
That's crazy. But it is what it is. It's the market. People, you know, hype the market.
Yeah. Apparently, I saw Matt Welty had a article about it on Complex. But they used to shop at a, like, store back in the day called Oasis to get, like, sneakers and shit.
And that's why they changed. They put the name.
Possibly. I don't know.
Okay. There could be some come.
I just kind of barely read the
article.
Yeah.
No, I feel you. So, I mean, it could be one of the influences for the band and stuff like that.
More of a Blur fan.
Blur. You showed me Blur. But I knew, I mean, of course, I knew some of the songs. I just didn't know the band's his name.
Yeah, well, most people know him from, oh, shit, the Gorillaz.
Oh, the song? Oh, the singer?
The band, yeah. The front man from Blur.
I forget his name.
Damien, like, Auburn.
Yeah.
Or something like that.
Yeah.
They kind of, like, disbanded around the same time as...
the Gorillaz.
Or I guess they disbanded before Oasis or whatever, but early 2000s or whatever, and he started doing Gorillaz stuff.
Gorillaz been popping off. Their last album, I think, came out last year, I believe. I liked it a lot. It's very good vibes. So I will say the Bad Bunny song on it's pretty random. Does not feel like it fits in the song, like in the album. But hey, get your bag, get your money. It was the number one song off that new album. So
yeah.
Still a good song. It just, to me, didn't fit the vibes of the album.
I feel you.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead and get into some housekeeping. Instagram at Premium Product Podcast. Show some love, follow, like, share our post. Twitter at @_PPP_. Twitter. Patreon. Sorry, I just got a brain fart.
You're in patreon.com/thePPP.
There you have access to this for $1 a month to become a Dutch master. You could donate, subscribe for more if you want. But with that, you get access to the Discord server, Minecraft server, and also an extra episode once a week. And once a month, we have our movie club. This month would be Shutter Island, which we're going to do a movie review next soon in the Patreon episode. So far I can say, interesting movie. I kind of guessed what happened from the beginning, but we'll discuss it more once,
I've not seen it yet. Yeah. At the time of recording.
So, we'll talk more about it next, on the Patreon. So
bit.
Also, from the Patreon, you can catch our streams, twitch.com/theppp show, and on YouTube. On YouTube, type in Premium Product Podcast or the PPP Show, and it'll pull up our streams. We're streaming.
Yeah.
COD.
Also, get access to the Discord as well through the Patreon.
Yeah.
It's been popping off.
A lot on COD, so, and I'm thinking about starting streaming Red Dead, but it's going to be more about just gameplay, not that much talking, because there's really nothing for me to talk about during the Red Dead. Just about what's going on while I'm doing it, but...
You have commentary.
Yeah, I can commentate, but it's just like, I'm just going to commentate what's going on of, like, moment, but...
Yeah, but also, like, if you get on, you could hit me up, we do, like, a kind of podcast through the stream type of shit.
Okay.
And if we get
good idea.
Discord set up correctly, you can like share screen or whatever. You could probably do it through PlayStation too.
Yeah, I think there's a button where you hit the broadcast to share screen.
Yeah.
So yeah, we can do something like that. That could help a lot logistically on just running podcasts and stuff, running it through the game.
Yeah.
And stuff. So YouTube there. I think that's it on the housekeeping. Rate. A review on all streaming platforms, Spotify, Apple Podcasts, YouTube, all of it. Just rate, review, comment, like, subscribe, all of it. Follow, do it all. Going into the fit check, very basic today. Wearing the Air Force One Cactus Jacks, Nike socks. Literally got off work at time recording and came straight here. So Coleman pants, and then I switched shirts because I was wearing a company shirt and I didn't want to talk about the company shirt.
Yeah.
So I had a plain white Hanes tee in the truck. So.
I'm going plain white Hanes tee as well.
Hey, Hanes boys so. Today. We on that no tax, scratch free. But yeah, that's all I'm rocking.
I went super WAP. rocking Adidas Rod Lavers, and then black Adidas tracksuit,
full tracksuit
with white tees.
I gotta get because I have the pants, but I need the top. I gotta get a full fit, black and white for sure. It's clean, simple. Adjust myself, and we can go ahead and get into our releases for this week. At time of recording, we have a few releases coming up, some big ones. First one on 9/11, we have the Nike Shock R4 returns in a classic OG color scheme. I feel like these were the ones I had. These look very similar to the ones I had.
9/11.
I mean, originally released in 2000.
I mean, that is, I think, like the OG colorway.
Yeah, because I remember I said I had like a metal gray with a red outlining, a red shock unit. But yeah, this comes back in the OG, came originally from the early 2000s, originally released in 2000. This OG colorway is coming at $150 on Nike.com for on September 11th. Classic shoe. I mean, as a kid, some kids were made fun of having these. I never was. I don't know why. Probably because my older brother was there, and if they were going to say something, they're going to go with him. And he was cool with shocks.
Yeah.
And some of the cool kids were cool with shocks, so that was nothing crazy. Either way, next shoe we have is the Dunk Low, and the apparently says Escargot colorway. I always thought it was like Sesame at first, but they're going, I guess... It's inspired from the French cuisine, the escargot, the snails.
Pretty good. Oh, yeah, escargot.
Never had it.
Pretty far.
I would try it, though.
It's basically just drinking butter.
Okay.
Like, if you've had, like, I guess oysters or something.
I've had oysters.
It's similar to that, but it's, like very small, and then it's just, like, butter, like, coated on top, and then, they kind of, like, creme brulee the butter almost.
Okay.
So it's like burnt at the top,
but they're small, so you're gonna get a lot of them, right?
Well, yeah, you get a little like dish, so you get a little like shooters and just eat them.
Just take shots of escargot.
Pretty far.
I'll try it. I'll try good ones. I'm not going to go to, like, let's say a fucking over here. The local.
The only time I've been on a cruise was they had, like dinner every night or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And you could go and you could get whatever you wanted on the menu. But, like, there's always, like, a starter and then, like, the main dish.
Yeah.
And then one of the starters was escargot.
So you're like, fuck it, let me try it.
It was, like, probably one of the better starters. And me and my cousin, like, got that almost, like, every night.
Damn.
It was pretty lit.
Damn, okay. So escargot is the move. Okay. Well, like this shoe, it could be the move. It has metallic silver accents. It says here the herb, garlic, butter, and paired with beige overlays for the green upper. It also includes a dinner plate graphic in the insoles and a white midsole and gum rubber outsole. The shoe is coming out for $125 on sneakers, and it comes out September 12th. I did not know about the insole. Yes, it does have a dinner plate. It looks like it's kind of raised, like a raised graphic. Pretty cool. Shoe is simple, and it looks good. It's clean.
Yeah, it's all right.
I don't need another dunk in my collection, like the basic one.
If I was wanting a dunk, it's not like the first thing I would go for.
Yeah, I don't.
Very Kermit the Frog ass.
Yeah, Muppets. Green. Muppets.
Similar green, though. September 12th, Bodega Asics.
Mm-hmm.
Coming out. $180. I think we talked about them more in depth.
Last week.
But pretty clean.
I will be trying to get these shoes.
Yeah, like kind of like a clear
mixed
with like cream and white mesh.
Pretty clean.
Like a neon green.
I need a mesh Asics. I don't have a mesh Asics, I don't think. No, because both my Asics are like leather, perforated leather, and then the Vivienne Westwood. That's like, I don't know what type of screen material that is. Need something that can breathe and move comfortably. The other ones I have to break in.
Yeah, but those are fire. I fuck with those.
Yeah. Fire for sure. Cop if you can cop on Bodega. Next one is Naked, and Naked is collaborating with Adidas on an Adidas Samba. This comes out September 13th for $140. I'm sorry. It's a classic Samba silhouette with a premium material, supple leather upper, and then lace overlays with the chic color palette. And it's pretty much all like a white shoe with the gray gum outsole and midsole.
Yeah.
It has some lacing on the stripes and on the heel tab, and then suede on the mud guard on the toe and the lace overlays.
They're okay. I would kind of just rather get like the OG white.
Yeah. I mean,
Samba over these.
Like, yeah. I guess this is more, I guess, frilly. If that's a word.
Yeah. I mean, it looks like it's suede on the, like, three stripes or whatever.
That's lace.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I think it's suede and then overlaid with lace.
Yeah.
Okay. Next one I have is a G-Dragon. G-Dragon's Peace Minus One Paranoise 3.0 and the Air Force One Low. This is the third Air Force he's dropped over the years. It has a premium leather, black paint overlay that potentially wears away over design like all the other Peace Minus Ones Air Forces. Has a hidden artwork underneath it. And it comes with, like, the swooshes come with different colors as well. Like, either, I think it's pink, yellow, blue, and those are the three colors. Yeah, so it's blue and yellow and pink. Oh, and then I guess it's, like, a green.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it looks like a green, yellow, pink, blue. And then the insole has his graphics on it, his design. And then the midsole has like the paint brush on the
I wonder what they look like when they're worn down.
I think that he posted a pic once early. But yeah, this shoe comes out September 14th on Nike.com and sneakers for $200. If you get these, post a picture and tag us and show us what it looks like underneath. Next one, just going to say it's the black. There's a white version and a black version of this shoe. It's the Deion Sanders Turf Max 96 in the Colorado Home and the Colorado Away colorway. September 16th for $170 is the Colorado colors of the Air Max Diamond Turf. Since Deion is now back with Nike and his school's a Nike shoe, they're doing a lot more Deion shoes.
I feel it's like the Colorado colorway
too. So it makes sense. Collegiately, a lot of people in the Colorado area is probably going to have this shoe. In Boulder.
Yeah.
Shout out to Kiana who graduated from there, the homie. Next shoe is the OG Jordan 1 grade school in the black raspberry. It's just part of the fall releases of Jordan. It's just a grade school shoe of either $120 grade school, $75 preschool, and toddler $65. September 17th, $120.
Don't buy your kids these. These are fucking ugly.
Yeah. I thought this was going to be a Halloween shoe by the colorway, but if it's just a black raspberry, what do kids...
They give me a Jordan Joker vibe.
Yeah, what kid, is, a big fan for, what demographic are you looking at kids that want black raspberries, I guess? Next one is one that we talked a lot about last week and it's finally releasing. It's the Air Max 90 in the reverse duck camo on September 19th for $140. A call for you.
I'm gonna try to get them.
Yeah. These shoes are nice. I love the red on it. We had a whole detailed about how this shoe came out when the whole duck camo era was coming out in the early 2010s. Next shoe is Alma Monier Jordan 4 on the women's in the While You Were Sleeping colorway. There's a 6 part of this collection. This is one of them. And to celebrate the 10 years of excellence of Alma Monier, it has a pinkish fossil stone hue. And then the second one also includes a metallic pewter and burgundy crush details. This shoe is dropping on September 19th on AlmaMonier.com and potentially on sneakers probably at a later date. This one's coming out as well as the Phantom version of it, which is the Phantom Metallic Pewter Violet Ore in all more colors. Out of both of these, the Fossil Stone is probably the one I like the most, but I don't want these as a Jordan 4.
Yeah.
If I want a Jordan 4, I'll probably just wait for the Black Cats to come out, honestly. Or honestly, I would love to get the Jordan 4 SB Pine Green that came out last year. I'm not really a big 4 fan, but I like how the shoe looks, but I just don't see myself
never had a pair of 4s.
I never had a pair of 4s. My brother is the same size as me, my older brother, and he has a pair of 4s. He likes them, but I never wore them.
I don't dislike them. I actually regret not buying a pair of the OVO Toronto Raptor
4s. When we were in Chicago?
Yeah.
Yeah, those were fire.
Because they had just a ton of them there.
Yeah, they had full sizing, full stock. It's almost like we were the first ones in the store.
Yeah.
I don't know if we were just walking by and, you saw that the OVO store was there. We went there. Nobody was in there. It was just us two looking at stuff. And then we walked down there, more people.
I wish he would do more Jordan shit. I guess he only has a deal with Nike or something.
Yeah,
I
think he's only with Nike. Yeah, I think in the beginning he had some Jordan, some type of Jordan deal with Nike.
Yeah.
But now it's just straight Nike and Nocta. So, yeah. Also, on September 21st, $140, you get the low top version of the Mocha Jordan 1 in the OG model. It's just the Mocha Jordan 1 high that came out 2-3 years ago, but in the low top. Yeah, these will sell. I won't say sell out, but these will sell.
Yeah.
September 21st for $140. And the last shoe I have is the Bad Bunny Adidas Gazelle Indoor in the Core White Gum colorway. This one is the Puerto Rico exclusive of it. So there's going to be a bigger general release later on, but for Puerto Rico, you are able to get them early on September 21st for $140. We discussed this. This was probably the best one he's done, Adidas wise.
Yeah.
Second one would be the San Juan one, the blue one. To me, I have his original not the original colorway, but that straight model, model that he did of the Forum Low in the black and the pink. But yeah, that's all the releases I have for this week. We can go ahead and get into some drops and announcements. Okay.
The announcements.
Hell yeah.
We got three Stone Island New Balance 991 V2s.
Stone Island going crazy with later New this year.
Pretty like monotone, like earth colors. You got an all black and a charcoal one.
Mm-hmm.
Like a olive green.
The olive green is catching my eye for some reason.
And then like an all cream.
Yeah. Out of all three of these, I would originally go with the black, but that green is catching my eye.
Yeah. Yeah, I'd probably get like the green or the cream one.
Yeah. Honestly. The black one's a little, I don't know.
I don't mind it.
I don't mind it, but out of the three, it'll be the third one I would get.
I feel like I have a hard time wearing all black shoes.
Mm. Give you some black Air Forces, man.
Well, I have my Sambas, but the Iraq Sambas.
Are those all black?
I mean, like 3M, and they got white stripes.
Okay.
Predominantly black. Dropping tomorrow at time of recording, so may sell out, may not. Supreme Clogposites, finally dropping. We got rumors that they were coming soon. They official images came out over the weekend, and it's a little disappointing. I was wanting a little more, but we get a Clogposite, two with racing graphics inspired by Drew D Performance, which is the Italian motorbike design company, I get, or I don't know, the people that created MotoGP graphics on bikes and shit.
Okay.
For like super bikes. So you get a like green, white, and red colorway.
Italy colors. Yep. Italy.
A blue, yellow, black one. Minions colors.
Big Minions fans over here.
And then you get a all black and with like red highlights.
Yeah.
And yeah. Supposedly you also have like a sock line coming with Nike.
Yeah. It's
also dropping.
It showed at the end like socks. And I like how the swoosh on the sock supposedly is 3M.
Yeah.
That's pretty fire.
Yeah.
To me, that's fire as hell. Yeah. I saw that right here.
Yeah. Yep.
The 3M. It's pretty fire.
So
I would for sure get this. The all black Supreme socks are clean to me.
Yeah, I don't think these are going to sell out. I may try to get a pair.
I'm for sure going to try to get a pair of the socks. For sure. Still need to get me a pair of the MoMA socks.
Yeah.
Hopefully still got them.
This white, black, and green and red colorway is kind of gone my eye.
That's the one that caught my attention is that one.
I like that one, and I like the like all black
the
blue, one.
The all black one? Yeah. You don't like the
Minion? I did kind of like the Minion one at first, but yeah. Then I was like, I think those you could actually wear more.
Yeah. I wear those in the house.
Yeah.
Cozy.
Chilling.
No socks.
But, another retro model coming back.
OG model, old school.
And one Tai Chi dunk contest making its return.
I haven't seen these shoes in forever. I remember in high. I know so many people that had these shoes.
I feel like they brought them back recently because I remember somebody during the pandemic was like, and one is back. They made like a YouTube video of him like playing basketball in them and like testing out the re-release.
Oh, it's probably that Wearchester's guy.
One of them.
Yeah, I think I know which one.
It was an Asian dude.
Okay.
Maybe
they got popping over there first.
Yeah.
I mean, the Tai Chi is the is a fire color.
But if you're into retro basketball shoes, they're coming out at and1.com for $130.
Apparently they're out now. Let me see. Let me see if I can pop them up and see what sizes are available right now.
The link to and1.com did not go through.
Yeah, I'm about to just go into n1.com on my just on Google search.
Yeah.
Yep. Tai Chi, $130. Oh, they come with four different colorways. They got the white and red.
Yeah.
They got the white and blue.
Okay.
They got the all black with the gum outsole.
Let me see those.
And like gray suede. Oh, hold on.
Okay. No.
And then they have an
all white.
All white with the green.
Yeah.
Yeah. So they have them as of right now. They have all sizes available from 7 to 13, and all of them besides the white and blue. I mean, the white and blue and the black. The white and blue and the black is out of a men's 11.5.
Yeah.
But they go up to a men's 15. So if you a men's 15, you can get these shoes.
All right. Oh, just because it popped up as an ad. Have you seen, so I guess some Korean company bought Fila.
Okay.
And they've been, like, relaunching a bunch of Fila stuff.
Yeah, I saw a little article. I didn't read it, though.
So they've launched, like, a new line called Fila Plus.
For fat people?
No.
Okay, thank God.
It's like, oh, I don't even see it on here. Let me look it up. It seems kind of like a Carhartt work in progress type thing. But, drawn inspiration from Fila's archives, Fila Plus presents a fresh take on classic silhouettes. With pieces that blend craftsmanship and authenticity suitable for everyday style. Open to discovering new territories and innovation, but always staying true to its roots. Fila Plus is more than just an extension of the brand. It's a tribute to the spirit of innovation that has always defined Fila. So, I mean, if you're not, I guess, super familiar with Fila, you only know of them as making, like, fucking ugly knockoff shoes.
Bulky shoes, like that. Yeah.
Back in, like, the 70s and, I guess, 80s, like, they were, like, a really big, like, kind of luxury kind of sportswear makers and stuff. They are from Italy. Like, they have...
Remember the Fila tracksuits?
Yeah.
The red, white, and blue.
They were kind of up there with like Sergio Tacchini.
Yeah. I feel like Sergio Tacchini.
I feel like they have like kept their kind of prestige.
Yeah.
Fila really.
I need to buy some Sergio Tacchini. Ain't nobody around here where I stay rocking that. And I need to rock that.
They had a collab with A$AP Nast not too long ago. That was fire.
Okay.
And some with Braindead as well.
Okay.
But supposedly they're relaunching this Fila Plus stuff, and they're going to have a bunch of kind of cool tracksuits and shit.
Hell yeah. We're going to see what they come out with, because they come out with some clean colorways and good premium material. I'll rock a Fila. I got the Fila fit already thought of.
I got the Fila Goshas.
Yeah.
I fuck with those shoes, heavy.
They're basically
like a knockoff Air Force One, but
Fila.
I don't know what the model is.
The Fila Go shoes.
Oh. Yeah, I'll look it up.
Gosha.
The T1 mid.
Fila Gosha T1 mid. Okay.
Mine are white and black.
Okay. Those aren't bad.
No. And it's like really nice leather. I believe Josh has these.
Okay. I've never seen him wear those. Kind of gives me like a Air Force and a 2.
Yeah.
Kind of mixed together.
Here's the one I got.
Those aren't bad at all.
Yeah.
Okay.
No, Fila's got some like kind of good like archival shit. It just sucks that they created the Disruptor.
That's what fucked it all up.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't like the Disruptor.
But I like some Fila stuff. But anyway, back to Nike.
Nike.
The Nike Dunk Low Halloween teasers have arrived.
See, the toe box is ugly to me.
Yeah, I don't like the toe box. Why? But I do like the like crackling.
Yeah, I mean,
kind of like yellow stuff.
This would be an all right sneaker if it wasn't for the toe box, for real.
Yeah, it's a black and like kind of vault colorway. But the vault is like
cracked leather.
Cracked leather. But then on the toe box, there's just a like what looks like a kind of like embossed like skull.
Yeah, like it's part, like you can't take that shit off. I would cut that shit off. This is a no for me.
Yeah.
I mean, I understand the theme, but like, where else, when else could you wear this shoe besides Halloween time?
Yeah.
Like, maybe if he was in the Opium Corps, maybe.
Yeah, for sure. Another shoe rumored to drop later in the fall. The Air Jordan 12 French Blue 2.0. I fuck with these pretty heavy.
These aren't bad at all, but what makes it the 2.0, the red stripe?
Probably. I believe the regular French blues are just blue all the way through. So
I wonder why they, I guess, I don't know. They're cool. 12s are comfortable.
Yeah.
I still prefer the ones I have though.
Speaking of Jordans, a one that went viral coming out in December.
Oh yeah,
the Jordan 4 net. They take the netting and like supersize it.
Dude, like it goes from like all the way up to the same level as the tongue.
Yeah,
and it goes over. Well, what's the inspiration? I guess I want to say. I really want to say like what the fuck, but I mean. No, this is a hell no for me. This is
It sees the shoe's signature netting expanding beyond its inclusion at the underlays, reaching upwards to the point where it shrouds the tongue. The heel tab also dons a net-inspired shape, as its initial white colorway sees an all-white finish adorn the sneaker, while golden Jumpman-themed ornaments are included on the top.
Who okayed this? This is what I want to know. This is what's going on wrong with fucking Jordan okaying shit like this. Someone needs to just be like, no, fuck no. This is stupid.
Yeah.
I know Michael Jordan did not approve of this.
Maybe he'd be doing that Marcus Jordan cocaine.
He was just on a bender. He's like, just do it, just do it, just do it.
Let's go. I need more net.
I need more net. I need more. I need more. I need more. No, I'm good on that. I would like to see those in the wild, just walking around, like, and see what fit they came off with and who the fuck's wearing.
Yeah. So, 2025, rumored Jordan 11, black, red, gray.
Where's the red?
I believe right on the...
Okay. Let me see.
I think it's just black, gray. But looks like an all black Jordan 11. These are kind of fire.
Oh, I see what the red is. These are nice.
I like these a lot.
They're not bad at all. These, this is a good 11.
Simple, good 11.
Simple.
Could it?
Could, can easily sell out. They can go with a lot of fits. The red is nice. I like it. It's a guess for me.
That's next year's. So what's this year's?
Oh,
It's a retro, isn't it?
Yeah.
Like the Concord?
I think it's the Concord. Let me see. Let me double check. But in like the OG.
Or the Space Jam. It's one of those two. I don't think it's the bread.
Let me see. It's the Columbia.
Columbia.
The Columbia this year.
The all white one.
The Legend Blue Columbia, yes. Yeah, I remember when the last retro of the Columbia, they called it the Legend Blues. I'm like, get that bullshit out of here.
Yeah. I don't remember if we brought it up last week, but first looks at the Stash.
Yeah.
Nike Air Max.
Yes, we did.
Your Air Force.
Not the Air Force, but.
So they're bringing this back, but they're changing it up a lot. And I'm not really a big fan of them changing it up.
Is that what they're going to come out with, or is that the original?
That's the new one.
Okay.
So it's got this weird kind of like mesh.
Yeah.
On with the like blue parts and stuff.
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe it's steel toe. Should be.
If it's steel toe, I'm buying them. Those are my new steel toes.
Well, like he has like a pair that are steel toe already.
Yeah. I'll be the only one with the steel toes. Those will be my dailies because I have to wear them for work. You can't wear those. They're steel toe.
You know my Air Force mids that are camo?
Yeah.
Those are steel toe.
Okay, yeah. Does it say steel toe on there or anything like that on it?
I think inside.
Okay, because that's what they're going to look for. They're steel toes. I'm going to walk in with those.
You can tell it's a steel toe. Oh,
I rock those. I need some new steel toes. 2025, you said?
Holiday 2024.
Oh, okay. I do need steel toes. I'll buy a cheap pair of toe then. Okay.
Trying to see if it says what they've updated. But I don't know. I haven't seen any complaints, but I could see people getting mad about the changes.
Yeah.
Then last Nike. The Zoom Spectrum. Or the whatever the fuck it is. Vaporfly 3. Zoom MX.
If I was a bigger, if I ran more, like more into the running, I would buy these. These would be my flexing.
But it's in the Spectrum colorway based off the, what is the shoe?
There you go.
I'm actually going to. The Nike Zoom Streak Spectrum, which Supreme also did a drop on a couple of years back.
Yeah, these will be like run like my day, like competition shoes. About to run a 5K, about to flex on y'all real quick. For sure, they're going to be broken in beforehand. Fire.
Last shoe drops I got. Norda. We talked about them a while back.
That they were going to release their own.
They do a hiking, kind of like trail running
shoe.
I've always thought they've been pretty cool.
I thought you see them
at a lot of boutiques and stuff.
I always thought they were cool too.
They're debuting, I believe, their first kind of like sneaker, even though I don't know. I would categorize all their stuff as sneakers.
Yeah, I could wear Nordas out and about. They don't look like a typical hiking shoe.
a trail running shoe.
But it looks almost similar to those Tom Sachs Field Generals.
Yeah. Okay. Now I see it.
I think they're better because, hey, fuck Tom Sachs or whatever.
Yeah, it's fuck Tom Sachs. One of our earliest podcasts right there is the Tom Sachs episode. Fuck him. Till this day. Notice how he disappeared in the wood in there.
So these are dropping... Spring 2025.
Okay.
So look forward to that.
Say a price tag or anything?
Did not.
Okay.
And then next up, a collab that I saw. Japanese company Shoe & Co. Collaboration with F-CE. Another, I think, Japanese company. And they make, I don't know what this, model of shoe is. It's like a loafer, kinda.
Let me see if I can find it real quick for you.
But it is a, Gore-Tex, like, pebbled leather. There is a black one and a tan one. Very fire. It appears they are all sold out. It is also in Japanese. So probably going to be pretty hard to get anyway.
For sure.
But I don't know. I've been thinking of trying to get more formal footwear.
Yeah, formal footwear is where it's at.
I got a couple different pairs of Clarks.
Yeah. If you want like a higher level footwear that's American made, Ala Edmonds is good.
Yeah.
There's also more. The best you can do is bespoke. And there's actually a big company here that makes like premium dress shoes and all that. I forgot what to call. I follow them on YouTube, but like they do like bespoke as well. So you can get you like one of ones made with like the best material out there. And then they also sell. That's where I buy a lot of my, shoe polish, shoe wax, and dress shoe cleaner, horse, you know, all that stuff, shampoo, soap, all that.
Yeah.
So shout them out. I forget their name, but, you know, they're local here in Dallas. Their factory is actually not that far from here. Warehouse, I should say, not factory, warehouse.
Yeah, 23,000 yen. So that's like probably what, $700?
I don't know. I'll look it up really quick just to make sure.
No, it's probably like $500.
$160.
For real?
23,000 yen is $159.86.
My conversions are off.
Oh, well, it's because the yen is really down. It's gone up a little bit, but not that much. Like by 0.003%.
Okay. So these are only like $160.
Yeah, it's good, a pretty good price. That's a good shoe. Shoe and Co. is good company. I know them. I follow them. Dime coming crazy. I seen this.
Yeah, so we got Dime's fall winter lookbook. Pretty lit looking. I like that sweater.
Yeah, I got a baseball jersey, the Dime hat, and mocha brown fire. That sweater's nice. The two-tone?
Yeah, all the wavy patterns and stuff, too.
Yeah, the hoodie is nice. It's with leather, too? Looks like a Carhartt. Oh, patchwork canvas and leather, it looks like.
Yeah.
God damn, why you gotta put him in that? Fuck. The Letterman jacket is nice, too.
Yeah.
Ooh, those shoes. What are those?
So Dime always drops on Saturdays, and they mix their drops up, kind of like Supreme.
Oh, they got Dime underwear? I'm a for sure cop.
Shit goes pretty quick, so.
They got Dime jeans, too, Dime sweats. It's a really nice look. Ooh, that pink Dime hoodie is fire. Yeah, those Asics are fire.
Yeah, maybe an Asics collab coming.
No, those are clean. Yeah, those are going to be a cop for sure. Yup. Looks like another Asics.
Some of the belts are fucking clean.
Yeah. They got like a hiking boot as well.
Yeah. Shout out to Dime Montreal.
Shout out to the Canadians over there, the Frenchies, the French Canadians. When's this drop? This September 7th, this Saturday? Perfect.
Another French brand, Lacoste, teaming up with Clot.
Clot and Lacoste. Fire.
Pretty kind of basic stuff.
Big gator. A lot of patchwork, looks like, or...
Yeah, very, like, Mandarin collar polo-looking stuff and whatever the...
Shout out to China.
...button-up style is. Will be available September 6th at the Lacoste web store.
That just gave me a... remind me. I had a work thing. I had a company call me asking me the origin of a part. It says here, someone put down... Taiwan, China. We will need to know if it's Taiwan or China. So I'm like, all right, let me give me 1 second, because I mean, I had to ask the person that did it, like, isn't Taiwan part of China? And I said,
depends who you ask.
I'm like, that's what I said. Depends who you ask. You're like, well, it seems to me it's Taiwan still part of China. I'm like, so what did I tell him? He's like, tell him China. I'm like, all right, China. Okay, bye. And afterwards, she was like, looking at it, and then she looked it up. She laughed. She goes, huh? Well, to some people, it's China is not part of, or Taiwan is not part of China. And to others, Taiwan is part of China. She goes, I don't know what to do. I just want to know which one, what do I need to pick?
Yeah.
I'm like, you're going to have to ask somebody. I don't know. If you don't know, I don't know.
Yeah. Ship shit to the fucking Chinese government.
Yeah. Hey, and they're like, what the fuck?
Commit treason.
Ship, yeah. I don't know. That's why I don't want to start, though. We don't want to start no bullshit with, like, some company or some country and be like, we become, like, the number one thing they talk about. And I'm like, nah.
Yeah.
We don't want no smoke. I don't want to lose my job.
We got Beams is fall, winter.
Beams
2024.
Report.
Oh, shit.
What we got? 2024 for Beams?
Yeah.
Five. Okay.
Starting off, you got a Digi Camo bomber jacket.
Cool.
Some kind of...
Love the baggy.
Real baggy, like acid wash denim.
My kind of baggy.
It's almost too. Like sweatpants.
Yeah.
Like how baggy it is. You got a big...
That stance, though.
Big, oversized puffer.
That would look like... I want one just to put it on.
On some big. Fat Albert shit.
It look like the goddamn Michelin Man. That hoe looks like a 5.
Okay, so she's wearing a... Or that person is wearing a hoodie underneath the puffer.
Still.
I think that's what's, like, bulking it up.
It wouldn't bulk up that much, though.
I think it is right there.
Okay. Well, it looks huge.
Because it seems to be an oversized hoodie.
Okay.
But it's all very basic stuff.
Nice.
And I can only see two pictures. Cool.
Okay, I can pull it up real quick.
Let me go to the official web store.
Okay. So you got the bomber jacket, the oversized, then you got, okay, something casual.
Okay.
Nothing too crazy.
Yeah, I believe this is all going to be Beams Plus, so it's not going to be real flashy.
Yeah,
pieces
all black, like looks like workwear with like the sleeves. The end goes around the thumb on some emo shit. Okay, big cozy Guy Fieri vibes right here. Big Guy Fieri. The jeans are fire though. I will say that.
I mean, the sweater is also kind of fire.
No, but it did.
Yeah.
If for people listening, it's the all black sweater, but with the flames coming out.
Can you screenshot that and text it to?
Yeah, give me a second.
So I can put that in the episode room.
Yeah, I'll send it to you here in a little bit. That's the back. So it's like wool or knit? Yeah.
Yeah, it looks like probably
really
like
fuzzy
wool or like mohair.
Okay.
Just your basic.
Basic brown, tan colorway. Pretty nice. Okay.
Ooh, some marble action.
Yeah, big marble. This is big.
Marble tech suit or tracksuit.
Like I'm in the streets. Roadman. I'm a roadman for sure in this pick.
Wait, oh, is that an Arc'teryx, I wonder?
I don't know. Yeah, I can't really see.
Yeah.
They ain't got like a
side sweater. A side beams note. Oh shit, let me try to find it.
These are fire.
Yeah, I like that denim
big
jacket.
Big Steve Harvey vibes on the pants though.
Yeah, kind of big trousers.
Oh, these are huge trousers. Yeah. God damn. Okay, this is clean. Leather sweater. Okay, big cozy grandpa vibes with the cardigan. Okay. Oh, this button up is a hoodie, and then the cargo jeans. And those Adidas's look fire though. You see that?
Yeah.
Okay. Digiprint on digital camo print on the inside of this windbreaker sweater thing.
A Supreme leaks news reporting upcoming Arc'teryx Beams collab. Here you can go scroll through this. This is one of their signature styles they do, that mismatching of patterns or whatever.
Okay.
Of like cross patterns or whatever, but they
like
do
the bag.
They do those a lot with Arc'teryx. So look forward to that coming. If you can get a hold of that jacket, you can flip it for some good money. But lastly, some Uniqlo news.
Uniqlo.
Uniqlo is a Japanese basics company.
Yes.
They do a bunch of graphic tees with like a ton of collabs. If you're into like anime stuff, Japanese like video games, stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely, they've probably done some type of collab with it. They also do a lot of artist series stuff, and so recently they just dropped a collab with Kaws plus Andy Warhol.
Okay.
So you can get some Kaws and Andy Warhol inspired gear from
Uniqlo.
And a little fun fact, all the locals out here, we're getting, I believe, three Uniqlos in the Dallas area very soon. Yeah.
I like Uniqlo. Last time I was in the Uniqlo was in New York. And then we went, did Chicago have one?
Yep.
Yeah, we went, we saw the Chicago one too. That's when the One Piece collab was coming out.
Yeah.
Nice.
So look forward to that. And that is all the news I got.
Oh, Uniqlo's in German. I can't read that.
But they're opening one in Galleria.
Okay.
One in Arlington, I believe.
Nice. George will be there. Shout out the boy.
One somewhere else, I believe.
Okay.
And then I think they have one in Houston.
Nice. Well, I only got two things on the news. First I have is the Jown and Timberland's collaboration with the 6-inch Gore-Tex boots.
Yes.
Two pairs, an all black and then like a, I guess, what color is that? What is it? Triple black colorway and ox blood. So it's a premium leather Timberland, all leather. With the Timberland logo on the side, on the lateral side with Jown logo as well. all simple. It's really good. Both are really nice. Subwoofer. I would look at both and see if you want to get these arriving in the fall. And the last one I have is the first.
I will say I really like that dark.
The ox blood?
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that one too a lot. We have a first look of the Kobe Bryant Air Force One Low coming out in the holiday of this year, $445. It's to commemorate Kobe Bryant. So they gave a Kobe Bryant theme Air Force One. So it's an all white Air Force with yellow on the tongue, not on the tongue, on the outsole, on the air, on the midsole, predominantly the swoosh, the heel tab, and a part of the tongue with also, they have the outline of the swoosh with purple and on the tongue purple. And then it has a Kobe Bryant logo on the heel as well. And has his signature as well underneath the tongue tag of the Nike Air Force One. So pretty nice shoe for my Kobe fans. This shoe will probably most likely going to sell out. So look forward to it on the holidays. And that's it.
Hell yeah. Well, that's the show, folks.
See you on the Patreon for the Shutter Island review.